وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. إن شاء الله تعالى today I want to cover a few verses إن شاء الله تعالى. الله سبحانه وتعالى he says فما أوتيتم من شيء فمتاع الحياة الدنيا وما عند الله خير وأبقى للذين آمنوا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون والذين يجتنبون كبائر الإثم والفواحش وإذا ما غضبوا هم يغفرون والذين استجابوا لربهم وأقاموا الصلاة وأمرهم شورى بينهم ومما رزقناهم ينفقون والذين إذا أصابهم البغي هم ينتصرون وجزاء سيئة مثلها فمن عفا وأصلح فأجره على الله إنه لا يحب الظالمين ولمن انتصر بعد ظلمه فأولئك ما عليهم من سبيل إنما السبيل على الذين يظلمون الناس ويبغون في الأرض بغير الحق أولئك لهم عذاب أليم ولمن صبر وغفر إن ذلك لمن عزم الأمور ومن يضلل الله فما له من ولي من بعده وترى الظالمين لما رأوا العذاب يقولون هل إلى مرد من سبيل وتراهم يعرضون عليها خاشعين من الذل ينظرون من طرف خفي وقال الذين آمنوا إن الخاسرين الذين خسروا أنفسهم وأهليهم يوم القيامة ألا إن الظالمين في عذاب مقيم ألا إن الظالمين في عذاب مقيم وما كان لهم من أولياء ينصرونهم من دون الله ومن يضلل الله فما له من سبيل. الله سبحانه وتعالى says فما أوتيتم من شيء فمتاع الحياة الدنيا. The ما in there is called شرطية and the من is بيانية. Okay, أي فما أعطيتم من أي شيء, whatever you give out, whether it's little or whether it's a lot. Okay, whether it be, يعني فما أوتيتم من شيء. Sorry, whatever, يعني أعطيتم, sorry, whatever you're given, whatever that's been given to you, whether it's little, whether it's a lot, whether it be kingdom and whether it be leadership, whether it be children, whether it be wealth, whether it be health, whatever it may be. يعني this is talking to everybody. The khitab is عام لجميع الناس. It's not specific to the Prophet. فما أوتيتم أي فما أعطيتم, whatever you be given, من أي شيء قليلا كان أو كثيرا, whether it be من ملك, من ملك, kingdom, من الرياسة, leadership, ومال, wealth, يعني وبنين, children, وصحة, health, وغير ذلك, and other than that, the khitab here is عام لجميع الناس. All of that Allah is saying, فَمَتَعُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. Which is, this is the رابطة لجواب الشرط, صح؟ يعني, وَمَتَاعُ is a خَبَرٌ لِمُبْتَدَئٍ مَحْذُوفٍ. It means, أي, فَهُوَ مَتَاعُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. الحقيرة, الفانية, يتمتع به, ثم سرعان ما ينقطع ويزول. أو يزول الإنسان عنه, فلا يغتر به. يعني, it, all of this is just the dunya, the small dunya, this dunya that won't remain. Whatever wallahi you're given in this dunya, all it is just the glitters and the glamours of this world. Temporary joy. As Allah said in another ayah, وَمَا جَعَلْنَا لِبَشَرٍ مِّن قَبْلِكَ الْخُلْدَ أَفَإِن مِتَّ فَهُمُ الْخَالِدُونَ. Allah says, Muhammad, before you, we have not made anyone remain on this earth forever. If you die, do they think they're going to remain forever? Then after that, Allah says, وَمَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَي مِنَ الثَّوَابِ الْعَظِيمِ وَالنَّعِيمِ الْمُقِيمِ. The remaining reward. Okay, وَمَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ, that which is with Allah, تَبَارَكُ وَتَعَالَى, in terms of reward, okay, in terms of blessings that are with Him, are خَيْرٌ, it's better. This is a خَبَرِيَّةٌ مُطْلَقَةٌ, okay, مِنْ مَتَاعِ الدُّنْيَا. يعني it's better than what? It's better than the dunya. The reward that you're going to get from Allah, تبارك وتعالى, brothers and sisters, is greater than the dunya and everything in it. وَأَبَقَى, and the reward that you're going to get يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ is going to remain forever. يعني أَدْوَم, أَبْقَى means أَدْوَم. Because the dunya is what? كُلُّهَا زَائِلَةٌ. All of it is going. وَمَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ, as for what with Allah, تبارك وتعالى, يَحُولُ وَلَا يَزُولُ بَلْ هُوَ نَعِيمٌ سَرْمَدِي. It's going to remain abadi. It's going to remain forever. نَسْأَلُ اللَّهَ مِنْ فَضْلِ. We ask Allah, تبارك وتعالى, from His virtue to give it to us. Then Allah says, لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. All of these blessings and this good are what? لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا خَاصَةً. It's specific to the believers. Which believers? الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا بِقُلُوبِهِمْ. They believed in their hearts. وَانْقَادُوا لِطَاعَةِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى وَعِبَادَتِهِ بِجَوَارِحِهِمْ. And they followed Allah تبارك وتعالى on their limbs. Okay? That's what Allah said in the ayah in Surah Yusuf. وَلَدَارُ الْآخِرَةِ خَيْرٌ لِلَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا. Akhirah, it is better for the people who come with taqwa. In Surah Al-Duha, what did Allah say? وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الْأُولَى. وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الْأُولَى. In Surah A'la, what did Allah say? وَالْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ وَأَبْقَى. يعني all of these verses Allah is elaborating on. Akhira is better than the dunya. Whatever wallahi you get in this dunya, brother and sister, it doesn't matter. فَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِّن شَيْءٍ فَمَتَاعُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. It's just the joy of this dunya. That's going to end. How long are you going to live for? 60 years? 70 years? The Prophet already told us, أَعْمَارُ أُمَّتِ مَا بَيْنَ السَّبْعِينَ سِتِينَ وَسَبْعِينَ وَقَلِيلُ مَنْ يَجُوزُ ذَلِكَ. The lifespan of my ummah is between 60 to 70, a little go overboard. Ah. Then Allah, تبارك وتعالى, He's telling us the people who are going to receive يعني the khair that's going to remain forever. Who are they? لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. First quality that was mentioned. This is why I was mentioning these ayats of the tafsir, because it gives us characteristics that we need to come with. The ones who are going to get Jannah, the ones that are going to remain that place, are number one, لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. They believe in Allah. يعني صدقوا بقلوبهم. In their hearts, they believed in Him. وَانْقَادُوا, and they submitted لِطَاعَةِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى, to surrender to Allah تبارك وتعالى, وَعِبَادَتِهِ بِجَوَارِحِهِمْ. They worshipped Him subhanahu wa ta'ala on their limbs. وَعَلَى رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. And also on their Lord, وَعَلَى رَبِّهِمْ. This is تَقْدِيم وَالتَّأْخِير. Remember, brothers, what we mentioned. تَقْدِيم and تَأْخِير. It was meant to be what? يَتَوَكَّلُونَ عَلَى اللَّهِ, right? يعني ويتوكلون على الله, but it became what? وعلى الله وعلى ربهم يتوكلون. Here it says it mentions وعلى ربهم يتوكلون, but the order normally in the Arabic language would be يتوكلون على ربهم. But because there was تقديم التأخير يفيد الحصر, it means أي وعلى ربهم خاصة يعتمدون اعتمادا كليا في جلب النفع ودفع الضر. They fully rely on Allah alone, no one else, in bringing them good and repelling harm from them. That's how these people are like. مع تمام الثقة بالله وصدق الاعتماد عليه والتفويض إليه, as Allah mentioned in the ayah, فعبده وتوكل عليه. They worship Him subhanahu wa ta'ala and they rely on Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. What's their quality as well? والذين يجتنبون كبائر الإثم. حمزة and كسائي and خلف, they read it as كبيرة with ifrad. They didn't read it as kaba'ir, as plural. They read it as a what? Ifrad, which is kabir al-ithmi. Whereas the other remaining qurra, they read it as jama', which is kaba'ir al-ithmi, which comes to the same meaning. There's no difference. The waw, وَالَّذِينَ يَجْتَنِبُونَ, the waw in there, it's عَاطِفَة فِي الْمَوَاضِعِ الثَّلَاثَةِ, in the three places. Okay? الَّذِينَنَا is a ism موصول مبني في محل جر عطفا على الموصول السابق. أي والذين, this is what it becomes, والذين, the ones, يجتنبون, who stay away from كبائر الذنوب, they stay away from what? The major sins. The one who does it will become a sinner for it. يعني تأثم مرتكبها. The one who does it will become آثم. أي توقعه في الإثم واستحقاقه العقوبة. The كبيرة, what is it, brothers and sisters? يعني the major sins, minor. Yes, there are major and there are minor. نعم. الكبيرة هي is كل ما نص الشرع على عن على أنها كبيرة. Anything that the شريعة refers to as a كبيرة is a كبيرة. That's number one. أو رتب عليها عقوبة خاصة دينية, or the Sharia specifically gives a specific punishment for it, a religious punishment for this thing. It becomes a major sin. أو دنيوية, or it does a specific worldly punishment for it. Okay, فهي محدودة لا معدودة, and it's restricted. It's not too. It's, يعني it is not. The major sins are not unrestricted. There's a number to it, okay? But it's restricted. If you want more to look at it, inshallah ta'ala, we might do it one time when we speak about the ayah, Surah An-Nisa, إِن تَجْتَنِبُوا كَبَائِرَ مَا تُنْهَوْنَ عَنْهُ. We might speak about it there, inshallah ta'ala. Also, وَالْفَوَاحِشِ, Allah mentions. They stay away from the kabira and they stay away from the fawahish. The fawahish is, here Allah ta'ala, he says, وَيَجْتَنِبُونَ الْفَوَاحِشِ. يعني they stay away from كبائر الإثم والفواحش. So they يجتنبون الفواحش. They also stay away from the فواحش. فواحش is كل ما فحش وقبح في الشرع وعرف المسلمين. It's whatever is filthy in the Sharia, okay, and also according to the customs of the people. Shirk in the Sharia is قبيح, فاحش. الزنا is also in the Sharia, also عرف المسلمين, is also something. قول الزور, idle speech and lying and false statements, all of those. Look how Allah used the word yajtanibuna, and He didn't mention and didn't say yatrukuna. Why? Because yajtanibuna ablagh min yatrukuna. Yajtanibuna is ablagh, has a more stronger meaning than yatrukuna. Why? Yajtanibuna al-kaba'ira wal-fawahish here means, it means they stay away from the major sins, okay, and the fawahish, the zina and the shirk and the qawl al-zur, and they also stay away from wa kullu ma yuaddi ilayha, and anything that might lead to it. وَيَبْتَعِدُونَ مِنْهَا, they distance themselves far from it. لِأَنَّ مَنْ حَامَ حَوْلَ الْحِمَى يُشِكُ أَنْ يَرْتَعَ فِيهِ. If someone is roaming around the edges of the sins, of course, most likely he's going to fall into it. صح? They're not like that. They're far away from it, these people. That's why Allah said, يَجْتَنِبُونَ, they distance themselves. Like in يَتْرُكُونَ means they don't do the sin, but they roam around its edges. وَإِذَا مَا غَضِبُهُمْ يَغْفِرُونَ. Allah mentions here the وَإِذَا مَا, that ma here, by the way, is a مُؤَكِدَ مِنْ حَيْثُ الْمَعْنَى. أي وَإِذَا غَضِبُهُمْ يَغْفِرُونَ. If they are angry, they forgive. يعني يَمْلِكُونَ أَنفُسَهُمْ عِنْدَ الْغَضَبِ. By the way, it doesn't mean وَإِذَا مَا غَضِبُوا. This shows that the believer can become angry. But then when they become angry, what do they do? يَمْلِكُونَ أَنفُسَهُمْ عِنْدَ الْغَضَبِ. They control themselves. They have strength over themselves. When they get angry, they control themselves. وَيَغْفِرُونَ لِمَنْ أَغْضَبَهُمْ, and they also forgive the one who angers them. يعني they conceal for that person and they overlook it. They just forgive it. As Allah mentioned about the characteristics of the muttaqin, He says, وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْضَ وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. They suppress their rage and their anger. وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ, and they forgive the people. Wallahi, brothers and sisters, the strong person is not the one who can wrestle everybody and etc. ليس الشديد بالسرعة إنما الشديد الذي يملك نفسه عند الغضب. As the Prophet said صلى الله عليه وسلم, the strong one is not the one who can wrestle and beat everybody. But the truth of the matter is, the strong one is the one who can control himself and his self-control. When he gets angry, he can control himself. عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها, she mentioned that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, she mentioned عائشة, وَمَنْ تَقَمَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صلى الله عليه وسلم لنفسه في شيء قط. وَمَنْ تَقَمَ رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لنفسه في شيء قط. The Prophet never ever retaliated and never fought for himself. إلا أن تنتهك حرمة الله, unless someone exceeded their boundaries in the religion of Allah تبارك وتعالى. فينتقم بها لله, then he will retaliate for Allah, not for himself. He will do it for Allah تبارك وتعالى. The characteristic Allah mentioned about them is subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَالَّذِينَ اسْتَجَابُوا لِرَبِّهِمْ, they obeyed Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. وَالَّذِينَ is a mawsula ma'atufun ala al-mawsuli fi qawlihi lil-ladhina, it's connected to lil-ladhina. And istajabu, the seen and the ta is lil-mubalagha, as you know in the Arabic language. أي فاستجابوا أبلغ, فاستجابوا, the word استجابوا is more stronger in meaning than the word أجابوا. As you know in the قاعدة in Arabic grammar, كلما كثر البناء غالبا, every time the structure of the word has more letters in it, the meaning also is extra. That's the قاعدة according to the grammarians. So استجابوا has a سين and has a تاء. So it's a little mubalagha. It's more emphasis. It is more than ajabu. Okay? يعني it means وَالَّذِينَ اسْتَجَابُوا لِرَبِّهِمْ, they obeyed Allah تبارك وتعالى, أي أجابوه باتباع رسوله, they obeyed Allah تبارك وتعالى in following His messenger, وَفِعْلِ أَوَامِرِهِ, by doing what He commanded them to do, وَاجْتِنَابِ نَوَاهِي, and stay away from that which He prohibited them from, وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةِ, they established a prayer. Okay, وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةَ, the wow is connected to two, هَذَا وَمَا بَعَدَهُ, anything that comes after from إِسْتَجَابُوا لِرَبِّهِمْ is connected to it. Okay, all of the عطف. Allah then says وَأَمْرُهُمْ, and their affairs is what? شُورَى بَيْنَهُمْ, يعني all of their general affairs is يَتَشَاوَرُونَ فِيهِ بَيْنَهُمْ, they don't just do anything, they consult. That's what they do, يعني they share one another. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he used to say to his companions, "Ashiru alayya ayyuhan nas." Oh people, give me your views and your opinions in matters. And when he started to do that, alayhi salatu wasalam, is when the ayah surah Ali Imran came down, "Washawirhum fabima rahmatin min Allah linta lahum wa law kunta faddan ghaliz al-qalbi lam faddu min hawlik fa'fu anhum wastaghfir lahum washawirhum fil amri fa idha azamta fatawakkal ala Allah." When that came down, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he used to consult the sahabas in matters. He would say to them, "Ashiru alayya ayyuha an-nas." ولذلك عمر رضي الله عنه, when he was wounded and حضرته الوفاة, death was close and he was about to die, what did he do? جعل الأمر شورا بين ستة من الصحابة. He called six of the companions and he said, "The matter is amongst you guys." And all of those six, they all agreed upon what? Uthman رضي الله عنه as the leader after him. Allah then says, وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ, the min here is liljins, not tab'idhiyya. And the ma, which is min, your ma, the min is liljinsi, it is not tab'idhiyya. It's like the ayah, وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءُ. It's like the ayah where Allah تبارك وتعالى, he says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ, all of those are jinsiyya, they are not tab'idhiyya. And the ma in min, your ma, that ma is a mawsoola, أي وَمِنَ الَّذِي وَمِنَ الَّذِي رَزَقْنَاهُمْ. Okay? وَمِنَ الَّذِي رَزَقْنَاهُمْ, that which we gave them, that's what it becomes. يُنفِقُونَ, they give. أَيُخْرِجُونَ الْمَالَ, they give out their wealth for Allah تبارك وتعالى. And giving out the wealth here encompasses الواجبة, the obligatory wealth that they have to give, like the zakat. And also the obligatory that they have to give, which is النَّفَقَةُ عَلَى الْأَهْلِ وَالْأَوْلَادِ, the providing for their children and their wives, they do that, which is wajib as well. ينفقون. And also on top of that, what do? They also give يعني, the zakat, which is mustahabbah, I mean the sadaqah, which is mustahabbah, which is hadiyah and gifts and others and those who need. وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَهُمُ الْبَغْيُ هُمْ يَنْتَصِرُونَ. Allah تبارك وتعالى, he mentions وَالَّذِينَ, the ones, إِذَا أَصَابَهُمُ الْبَغْيُ, الْبَغْيُ here means الظُّلْمُ وَالْعُدْوَانِ, if someone oppresses them and wrongs them. وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا بُغِيَ وَعْتُودِيَ عَلَيْهِمْ, if someone goes, exceeds his limits, transgresses on them, يَنْتَصِرُونَ, they give victory, مِمَّنْ بَغَى وَعْتَدَى عَلَيْهِمْ لِشَجَعَتِهِمْ وَقُوَّتِهِمْ وَقُدْرَتِهِمْ عَلَى الْانْتِصَارِ مِمَّنْ ظَلَمَهُمْ. They have strength, they're not weak people. If someone oppresses them and wrongs them, they get their rights. And Allah تبارك وتعالى, he is praising them, because this is a praise for somebody having strength and also having the ability to support, يعني defending himself. And that these are not, ليسوا بعاجزين, they're not weak people. ولا ضعفاء ولا أذلاء, they're not. Okay? So this is what Allah is praising them for, having strength and for having يعني ability. But it's not here, the praise here, brothers and sisters, is not the retaliation. Okay? Yani the Sharia is not to retaliate. The Sharia is not praising that. What he's praising them here for is the qudrah ala al-intisar. They have the ability to get victory for themselves, and that they're not weak. وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَهُمُ الْبَغْيُ هُمْ يَنْتَصِرُونَ. يعني when they are afflicted with transgression, someone is over exceeding their boundaries and going overboard with them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, they're brave, they're not cowards. They're braves, they're brave. ولذلك عوف بن مالك رضي الله تعالى عنه, he mentioned أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قضى بين رجلين, the Prophet judged between two men. فقال المقضي عليه لما أدبر, the one that it was judged for, he said, when he turned away, he said, حَسْبِيَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلِ. He said, حَسْبِيَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلِ. فَقَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمَ, he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَلُومُ عَلَى الْعَجْزِ وَلَكِنْ عَلَيْكَ بِالْكَيْسِ فَإِذَا غَلَبَكَ أَمْرٌ فَقُلْ حَسْبِيَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلِ. So in this hadith, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَلُومُ عَلَى الْعَجْزِ. Allah تبارك وتعالى blames, سبحانه وتعالى, على العجز, weakness. وَلَكِنْ عَلَيْكَ بِالْكَيْسِ. But apply intelligence, brothers and sisters. فَإِذَا غَلَبَكَ أَمْرٌ فَقُلْ. If something overcomes you, say, حَسْبِيَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلِ. So the believer is not a weak person. He's strong. He doesn't take being pushed around. And he's got the يعني, strength and the quwwah. He's not a coward. Also, Imam Muslim narrated in his Sahih, and Ibn Majah, من حديث أبي هريرة, the Prophet said, المؤمن القوي خير أحب إلى الله من المؤمن الضعيف. The strong believer is more beloved to Allah تبارك وتعالى and greater than the weak believer. وفي كل خير, all of them have good in them. لكن احرص على ما ينفعك, strive to that which will benefit you, واستعين بالله and seek help from Allah. ولا تعجز, and don't be lazy and weak. وإن أصابك شيء, if something afflicts you, فلا تقول, don't say, لو أني فعلت كان كذا وكذا, if I was to do such and such, it would have been this. Don't say that. ولكن قل قدر الله, say, well, Allah تبارك وتعالى willed, has happened, وما شاء فعل, and he does what he wishes. فإن لو تفتح عمل الشيطان, فإن لو تفتح عمل الشيطان, لو opens the door of الشيطان. Okay. After that, Allah تبارك وتعالى, he says, وجزاء سيئة سيئة مثلها فمن عفا وأصلح فأجره على الله إن الله لا يحب الظالمين ولمن انتصر بعد ظلمه فأولئك ما عليه من سبيل إنما السبيل على الذين يظلمون الناس ويبغون في الأرض بغير الحق أولئك لهم عذاب أليم ولمن صبر وغفر إن ذلك لمن عزم الأمور. Allah تبارك وتعالى, he says, وجزاء سيئة سيئة مثلها. When Allah تبارك وتعالى, he praised their ability in being able to give victory to themselves, Allah تبارك وتعالى commanded them to be just, to be fair, which is المماثلة في المجازات. If you're going to get your rights back, remember, equal, don't go overboard. And Allah تبارك وتعالى, he prohibited them from going overboard. Remember, a lot of the times when people want to get back their rights, they go overboard. And they then become the oppressor, and the other person becomes the oppressed. The tables change. So Allah تبارك وتعالى, he says, وَجَزَاءُ سَيِّئَةٍ سَيِّئَةٌ مِثْلُهَا. يعني جَزَاءُ سَيِّئَةٍ مَنْ أَسَاءً يُجَازَى بِسَيِّئَةٍ. If somebody does something bad to you, respond to that. Just يعني بِعُقُوبَةٍ مِثْلِهَا بِمِقْدَارِهَا مِنْ غَيْرِ زِيَادَةٍ. As Allah mentioned in Surah Al-Baqarah, فَمَنْ اَعْتَدَى عَلَيْكُمْ فَاعْتَدُوا عَلَيْهِ بِمِثْلِ مَا اَعْتَدَى عَلَيْكُمْ. If someone exceeds his limits, does something to you, do exactly what they did to you. Okay? Also Allah تبارك وتعالى, he said in Surah Al-Nahl, وَإِنْ عَاقَبْتُمْ فَعَاقِبُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا عُوقِبْتُمْ بِهِ. أي بِمِثْلِ مَا عُوقِبْتُمْ بِهِ كَمًّا وَكَيْفًا وَنَوْعًا. The amount has to be the same, the how has to be the same, the type has to be the same. You can't just... By the way, brothers and sisters, if this person does evil to you, what you're doing is actually not evil. What you're doing to them is justice. So why did Allah تبارك وتعالى refer to it as وَجَزَاءُ سَيِّئَةٌ سَيِّئَةٌ مِثْلُهَا. And the first person did سَيِّئَةٌ, yes. Like in the next, the response is not سَيِّئَةٌ. It's عَدْل. It's justice. It's your rights. This is what the scholars, they call الْمُشَاكَلَةِ. They call الْمُشَاكَلَةِ. الْمُشَاكَلَةِ means this was mentioned and the response just became the same. That's called, it's a type of way the Arabic speak. And that's what Umar radiallahu anhu was saying when he said, if this is an innovation, then a good innovation it is. It's just min bab al-mushakalah. And I expanded on that in great details in my podcast when I spoke about the issue of innovation. the Hot Seat Podcast. Okay, brothers and sisters. Also, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala mentions to us in the Quran the issue of al-adlu hatta fil qisas. If the person chooses for his rights to be brought back for him, and they raghibu fi istifa'i haqim, they want their rights to be given to them. Whether it be your nafs to be taken from you. You killed someone from us, we want you to be killed. Ah. Or you wounded someone, we want you to be wounded for it. Or you took wealth, we want the wealth back. Other than that, Allah mentioned in the Quran, Allah says, وَكَتَبْنَا فِيهَا وَكَتَبْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ فِيهَا أَنَّ النَّفْسَ بِالنَّفْسِ وَالْعَيْنَ بِالْعَيْنِ وَالْأَنْفَ بِالْأَنْفِ وَالْأُذُنَ بِالْأُذُنِ وَالسِّنَّ بِالسِّنِّ وَالْجُرُوحَ قِصَاصٌ. But then look what Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala mentioned after that. He said, فَمَنْ عَفَى وَأَصْلَحَ فَمَنْ عَفَى عَمَّنْ أَسَائِلِهِ. Someone wronged you, you forgave them. وَأَصْلَحَ, and you قَصَدَ بِعَفْوِهِ الْإِصْلَاحَ. You forgave him to perfect the air, the situation. You want this toxic environment that you just want all of that to go. That was the reason why you forgave them. فَأَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ. Your reward is with Allah. The fact here is رَابِطَةُ لِجَوَابِ الشَّرْطِ, which is فَأَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ. The reward of his is with Allah تبارك وتعالى. يعني قَدْ تَكَفَّلَ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ بِهِ. Allah تبارك وتعالى. وَأَكْرِمْ بِهِ مِنْ أَجْرِ اللَّهِ. وَأَعْظِمْ بِهِ مِنْ جَزَاءِ. Allah تبارك وتعالى will take care of you. فَأَجْرُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ. Brothers, the reward hasn't been mentioned here. So if Allah says that to you, imagine what it's going to be. فَأَجْرُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ. Your reward is with Allah. Brothers, should you choose that over the retaliation or not? Also, Allah تبارك وتعالى, he says to us in the Quran, وَإِنْ تَكُ حَسَنَةً يُضَاعِفْهَا وَيُؤْتِ مِنْ لَدُنْهُ أَجْرًا عَظِيمًا. يعني the normal reward that people do, Allah تبارك وتعالى, he tells us that he multiplies it for them and he brings them a lot of reward. فَمَا بَالُكَ, would you then now think about something he chose not to mention the reward for it? It has all the other rewards that you've heard for good deeds, but something else is being seen here as well. Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad, he said, إِذَا أَتَاكَ رَجُلٌ يَشْكُو إِلَيْكَ رَجُلًا فَقُلْ, say to him. Someone comes to you complaining about another person, say to them, يَا أَخِي أُعْفُ عَنْهُ. Brother, forgive him. فَإِنَّ الْعَفْوَ أَقْرَبُ لِلتَّقْوَى. Forgive him, for forgiveness is closest to piety. فَإِنْ قَالَ, if he says to you, لَا يَحْتَمِلُ قَلْبِي الْعَفْوَ. My heart cannot take forgiving. وَلَكِنْ أَنْتَصِرُ. I want my rights. I want to retaliate. كَمَا أَمَرَنِ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. As Allah commanded me. فَقُلْ لَهُ, then say to him, إِنْ كُنْتَ تُحْسِنُ أَنْ تَنْتَصِرَ. If you have the ability to really just take your rights and not to go overboard, then do so. وَإِلَّا فَرْجِعْ إِلَى بَابِ الْعَفْوِ. And if you can't, and you're scared that when you take your right back, you might get emotionally invested and go overboard, then go back to the first, which is to forgive. فَإِنَّهُ بَابٌ وَاسِعٌ. Because it's a wallahi vast door. فَإِنَّهُ مَنْ عَفَى وَأَصْلَحَ فَأَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ. Fudayl said, because wallahi, the one who forgives and perfects the situation, his reward is with Allah. وَصَاحِبُ الْعَفْوِ يَنَامُ عَلَى فِرَاشِهِ بِاللَّيْلِ. The one who forgives, at night he will sleep on his bed better. وَصَاحِبُ الْإِنْتِصَارِ يُقَلِّبُ الْأُمُورَ. Whereas the one who wants to retaliate and get his rights back now, all night he will be tossing and turning his thoughts about what, how, what. Ibn al-Qayyim, look what he said. Allahu Akbar. Wallahi, this kalam of Ibn al-Qayyim yastahiqu an yuktaba bima idha. He said, wallahi, Ibn al-Qayyim said this. He said, وَلَنْ تَقَمَ أَحَدٌ لِنَفْسِهِ إِلَّا ذَلَّ. There is not a person who tried to retaliate for himself except he gets humiliated. وَلَوْ لَمْ يَكُنْ إِلَّا بِفَوَاتِ عِزِّ الْعَفْوِ. And if there was no other harm in retaliating other than the fact that you're going to lose the honor of forgiving, that would be enough. That would be enough. وَلِهَذَا, and because of that, مَنْ تَقَمَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ لِنَفْسِهِ قَطْ. The Prophet never retaliated for himself. عليه الصلاة والسلام. Never revenge for himself. عليه الصلاة والسلام. He did it always for Allah's sake, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for the religion of Allah. وَلِذَلِكَ الْإِمَامُ الشَّافِعِيُّ, he said, لما عفوت ولم أحقد على أحد أرحت نفسي من هم العداوات. الله أكبر. When I forgave ولم أحقد على أحد, and I never had حقد and this animosity in my heart towards them, أرحت نفسي, I gave myself ease from all of the feeling of animosity and hate. إنه لا يحب الظالمين. Allah says after that, the ending of the verse, Allah says إنه لا يحب الظالمين. This is الجملة التعليل لما قبله, which is أي لا يحب الظالمين المعتدين. Allah does not like those who exceed their limits and oppress. They are who لكن وهم الذين يبدأون بالسيئة. They're number one, they're the ones who start the wrong to the people. And also they are والذين يعاقبون عليها بأشد من مثلها. And they are also the ones who retaliate more and beyond their rights. وَلَمَنْ انْتَصَرَ بَعْدَ ظُلْمِهِ. The one who goes out there to get his rights after he was wrong. The wow, he is عَاطِفَ. The lamb وَلَمَنْ انْتَصَرَ. The lamb in there is lamb للتوكيد. في الموضعين, in both places. وَلَمَنْ انْتَصَرَ مِنْ ظَالِمِهِ وَاسْتَوْفَى مِنْ حَقِّهِ. And يعني the person who gets his victory, يعني gets his rights from the oppressor. And he gets where his rights is. Okay? That's what it means. وَلَمَنْ انْتَصَرَ بَعْدَ ظُلْمِهِ. ظُلْمِهِ, there's a ha in there, which is a ضمير. يَعُودُ, where does it return back to? إِلَى الْمَظْلُومِ, to the oppressed. أي بعد ظلم, after oppression. فَأُولَٰئِكَ. This إشارة is, it goes back to وَلَمَنْ, لَمَنْ. It goes back to that, in terms of its meaning, okay? Because فَأُولَٰئِكَ is a jama'. And the man here shows jama as well. فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَا عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْ سَبِيلِ. يعني فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَا عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْ سَبِيلِ. This min is مُؤَكِّدَ لِعُمُومِ النَّفِي, because ma here is a negation. أي مَا عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْ أَيِّ سَبِيلِ. Yeah, there is no harm upon them. There is no wrong in this person. لَا حَرَجَ وَلَا مُؤَاخَذَ. There's nothing to يعني hold against that person who retaliates and gets his rights. لأنهم إنما أخذوا حقهم, because what they took is their rights. That's why the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, المستباني ما قال فعل البادي منهما ما لم يعتدي المظلوم. الله عز وجل, he then said, إنما السبيل على الذين يظلمون الناس. إنما is أداة حصر, okay, إنما السبيل, which means أي ما السبيل إلا على الذين يظلمون الناس. The harm, the sin is upon who? على الذين يظلمون الناس. I'm not wrong for retaliating and getting my rights. But the one whose harm and sins are upon is the one who oppresses. أي يعني على الذين يظلمون الناس. أي يعتدون عليهم في دمائهم. They exceed their limits when it comes to people's bloods. وأموالهم and their wealths. وأعراضهم وغيره وغير ذلك. ويبغون في الأرض, and they are also what, أي ويعتدون في الأرض ويتجاوزون الحد في حق الله تعالى بالمعاصي وفي حقوق الخلق. They're going overboard, exceeding their limits. They're not looking at what Allah commanded and what Allah prohibited. They're doing it as they wish. And guess what? They're not looking at the people's rights. They do it. ويبغون في الأرض, أي ويعتدون في الأرض. They are exceeding their limits on this earth. بغير حق. This is a بيان للواقع. لأن البغي كله بغير حق. بيان للواقع. بغير حق, it doesn't mean that there is a time when ويبغون في الأرض, they are exceeding their limits on this earth, it's fine. No, he is just بيان للواقع. Allah is just clarifying the reality of it. So there's no مفهوم in it. ابن القيم رحمه الله, he mentioned something very powerful in his كتاب الروح. He says فذكر المقامات الثلاثة. Allah mentioned three stages. What are they? In this ayah, he says مقام العدل, the stage of justice. وأذن فيه, and Allah permitted it, which is the person, he gets his rights. This is مقام العدل, and Allah permitted that. وأذن فيه, he said you can do it if you want to. There's مقام الفضل, the virtuous stage. وندب إليه, and Allah encouraged us to go towards that one. Then there is the مقام الظلم, the station of oppression. وَحَرَّمَهُ اللَّهُ, Allah prohibited it. So you're not allowed to retaliate more and beyond what the person did to you. That's just haram. It's you're now the oppressor. Okay? But there is the مقام العدل, justice, fairness. He slapped you, he slapped his wrist again. He slapped your wrist, you slapped his wrist. خلاص, go, everyone go. There's the مقام الفضل, the best one. Little choose that. Which is to forgive. And to forget. Allah then says subhanahu wa ta'ala, أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ عَظِيمٌ. Those people who are oppressing the people, وَيَبَغُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ, and they are looking to bring mischief on this earth, بِغَيْرِ حَقٍّ, for them is what? عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. أي مؤلم شديد موجع أي punishment that's going to burn their body, hurt them severely. What's it going to hurt first of all? First of all, it's going to hurt their hearts by just reading about it in the Quran. Before they come to the يوم القيامة, موجع معنوية للقلوب. Right now, before they come قيامة, they're going to, Allah is going to bring to them the oppressors. In this world, Allah is going to hurt their hearts. وحسيا للأبدان يوم القيامة, Allah is going to سبحانه وتعالى burn their bodies, the oppressors and the wrongdoers. Allah then says, وَلَا مَنْ صَبَرَ. After Allah تبارك وتعالى spoke about مقام العدل and مقام الفضل, Allah تبارك وتعالى, مقام العدل and مقام الظلم. Now he's going to talk about مقام الفضل, the station Ibn al-Qayyim referred to as the virtuous station, which is وَلَا مَنْ صَبَرَ, anyone who forgives. Okay? على إساءة من أساء إليه وآذاه فلم ينتصر. He doesn't take his rights. He says, أخي, I forgive you. I forget. I will move on. وغفارا. صبرا, it means to forgive. وغفارا means a سترى ما حصل له من إساءة. He doesn't ever mention what happened between the two of them. إن ذلك, that is لمن عزم الأمور. إن ذلك, here it means إن ذلك الصبر على إساءة من أساء وستر إساءته والتجاوز والعفو عنه بعد القدرة لمن عزم الأمور. The lamb here is what? It's lamb للتوكيد. It's emphasis. This is the يعني لمن الذي يعزم عليه من الأمور. This is the kind of thing a person should make an unwavering conviction on. It is one of those actions that you should really be determined to achieve. What a good thing to do. Is what Allah mentioned in the Quran. ادفع بالتي هي أحسن فإذا الذي بينك وبينه عداوة كأنه ولي حميم وما يلقاها إلا الذين صبروا وما يلقاها إلا ذو حظ عظيم. I'm going to stop there inshallah ta'ala, even though I recited more verses, but I'm going to stop there inshallah ta'ala because it's become too long. I'm going to stop there inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan, and Allah and his messenger are both free from it. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.